In this video, I show you how I made these remote controls Audi R8. I've made several other 3D printed remote controlled cars in the past, but this one is modular and uses three modules. The servo, the electronics and the rear axle module. I printed all the parts with my Anycubic Viper and the material I used is PLA. But I also used PETG for the gear and the rear axis, and TPU for the front and rear tires. For the rest, I've used the following settings in Cura to print the parts successfully. For this project, I used threaded inserts instead of nuts. I can easily melt these into the printed parts with the help of a soldering iron, and that way I need less space to fix the bolts. Now that I have threaded inserts in all parts, I can start assembling the car. I start with mounting the servo or steering module, and as you can see, I use the first electronics part here, the FS90 servo motor. When the servo module was mounted, I could start on the motor or the electronics module, and it contains various electronics parts. Namely the motor, the electric speed controller, the receiver, and also two fans to provide the components with cooling. As you can see, I mount a pulley on the motor with 20 teeth, on which I will put a GT2 belt laser, which will be also connected to the pulley on the rear axle with 40 teeth, so that I have a gear ratio of 1 to 2. This means that for every revolution that the engine turns, the rear wheels will turn off a rotation. The rear axis has now also been mounted, so I can start assembling the body of the Audi R8. Before I assemble the three modules and completely assemble the car, I will first talk about the electronic circuit. On this diagram you can see how I connected everything. And then I'm going to mount the servo and the electronics module on the chassis. I also mount the body with the last 10 bolts. And this is the result of the remote controlled Audi R8. You can download all the STL files via Kult 3D. Thank you so much for watching, and I see you in the next video.